Good morning. It is Tuesday, May 19th, 2020. Go ahead and stand up. We're going to do our pledges today. We will stand with, for, and do, open, the Christian flag. So right hands over your hearts. Pledge to the Christian flag. Ready and begin.
I pledge allegiance to the Christian flag and to the Savior, for whose kingdom it stands, one Savior, crucified, risen, and coming again with life and liberty for all who believes.
Pledge the Bible. Let me use that one.
It's right there.
Where? I'm just missing it.
It's on the table.
Oh, I see it now. Okay, pledge the American flag. Ready, begin.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Grab the Bible. Good morning. So it's pledged to the Bible. Are we ready?
I pledge allegiance to the Bible, God's holy word. I will make it a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. I will hide its words in my heart that I might not sin against God.
Okay, let's go ahead and open in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we're so thankful for this glorious new day that you've given us, Lord. We're thankful for our families and our friends, Lord. We're thankful for this school that we have to come to, or at least have extended learning. So, Lord, we just ask that you would touch those that are sick, and we ask for healing on those, Lord. We just want to lift up this time of Bible study and ask our minds to be open to your word. And we just ask this in your name, Lord Jesus. Amen.
Amen. All right, couple more days we have to practice all of our Ephesians 6 through, or 10 through 17. 6, 10 through 17. Ready and begin.
A final word. Be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. Put on all of God's armor so that you will be able to stand firm against all strategies of the devil. For we are not fighting against flesh and blood enemies, but against evil rulers and authorities of the unseen world, against mighty powers in this dark world, and against evil spirits in the heavenly places. Therefore, put on every piece of God's armor, so that you will be able to resist the enemy in the time of evil. Then, after the battle, you will still be standing firm. Stand your ground, putting on the belt of truth and the body armor of God's righteousness. For shoes, put on the peace that comes from the good news, so that you will be fully prepared. In addition to all of these, hold up the shield of faith to stop the fiery arrows of the devil. Put on salvation as your helmet
and take the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God. Ephesians 6, verses 10 through 17.
Time for worship.
So Lit Mobile just sent me this solar wireless battery pack. I'm excited. Let's see what's inside. I really like the build.
There's a place where mercy reigns and never dies. A place where streams of grace flow deep and wide. For all the love I've ever found comes like a flood, comes flowing down. At the cross,
for today, we find it in Acts 9, verses 36 through 43, and the story is about a woman by the name of Dorcas, but she also had the name Tabitha. She had two different names. So, And what she did is she was a widow and she helped make clothes for others. And she was also a disciple. Tabitha, who was also called Dorcas, lived in the city of Joppa and was a disciple of Jesus. The Bible says that she was always doing good and helping the poor, especially other widows. When she died, everyone was very sad. Other Christians in Joppa had heard about the Apostle Paul, healed a paralyzed man in the city of Lydda. So two men were sent to get Peter to come to her house. And when Peter arrived, all the widows around were crying. They were showing Peter like the clothes and stuff that she had made for them, showing that, you know, what a wonderful person she was and how beautiful these clothes were and how she tried to help others. Peter sent all of the people out of the room. And he stayed there alone with her. He went and he kneeled down next to her and he prayed. By the power of God, Dorcas opened her eyes and looked at Peter. Dorcas had come back to life. Another miracle that was done in the name of Jesus. When word of what Peter had done got out around the people, that they all came to him. Because of this miracle, many people believed in the Lord Jesus Christ that day.
Wow.
So, a couple things here. A disciple, if you don't remember, is someone who follows something or someone. And then in Acts 2, we learn that the disciples of Jesus were given also these powers to perform miracles and help people. And that was to help them to understand about the miracles of Jesus and to become believers of Jesus. So understand that the good news about Jesus was true. So what did you guys learn from this story? Miss Batchelor, what did you learn from this story?
It reminds me of other stories that we had. We have Lazarus that was raised from the dead. We also have the little girl and Jairus's daughter who had died, and they said, "Don't come," and Jesus went anyways and raised her from the dead. So it reminds me that Jesus gave the disciples the same power that he has. But what's really interesting about that too is because we have the power of the Holy Spirit, we have that same power as well. So that's what it reminds me of.
How about you, Miss East?
You know, one of the things that really blesses me about this story is from the book of James. It says that real religion is taking care of widows and orphans. And this woman, Dorcas or Tabitha, that's what she did. She took care of the widows and she took care of the orphans. So she was really doing
the Lord's work.
Yeah, she was doing Christianity. She was a Christian, but she was doing it. And that was hard in those days to make cloth and then to sew the cloth. And I think she also probably knitted and made blankets for people. She was very loving and she used her talents and abilities to be a Christian. And so, of course, when she died, that was a huge loss.
And it shows a lot about her because all the people around were all very upset.
They were very sad. And that's, you know.
That's really a testimony of who you are, is by how people remember you.
Exactly.
So you are going to pull out 205 and 206. 205, you're going to do on your own. It's the path that Peter took to get to Dorcas or Tabitha. So you're going to do that page on your own. And we're going to look at the top part of page 206, okay? So it says we're going to place the order of place these sentences, basically, and we're going to order of events that they happened. So the ones that we're looking at, we've got Tabitha or Dorcas got sick and died. This miracle was known throughout Joppa. Peter kneeled down to pray and then said, "Tabitha, arise." And Tabitha or Dorcas did many good works. So what do you guys think happens first? Let's see. Tabitha did many good works. So because she did many good works, what was the next thing that happened? she got sick. And then the people, remember, were very, very upset. So they went to go find Peter to help. And then after that, Peter knelt down to pray and said, "Tabitha, wake up." And she opened her eyes. And so the last one, number four, this miracle was known throughout Joppa. So you're going to go ahead. We helped you with the top part, and you're going to go ahead and finish the bottom part on your own. Bye.